Hi, so in this video, we're going to take a look at a program called Enter. Enter is a program that you can use to run commands when a file changes. So this can be used for a variety of different things like LaTex recompilation or recompiling some software when the source files change or something like that. So in this video, we're going to just take a look at a few options of Enter and how I generally use it. And let's get into it. So here I have a file. This is a LaTeX file. This has some text in it, and I have a terminal pulled up here, actually three. So let's take a look at how we generally do it. So if I ls here, you can see this is my output. So this is the file that I have, and this is the one that we're gonna take a look at today. So let's ls enter, ls the name of the file. We pipe that into enter. And then the command that we need to run. So to compile LaTeX, you would generally do PDF LaTeX, and then the name of the file, and then the name of the output file, so .pdf. So let's go into this terminal, let's ls, you see hi.txt here. Let me run it. And if I now ls here, you can see that it brought up this. So it has the hi.pdf and the two other files. So let's just open up the hi.pdf here. So you can see it right here. This is the text that we have. So if I now write this, you can see that it changes. Let's copy this. This is some new text. Okay. Let's write, and you can see that it updates. So that is the very base case of Enter, and it is a really cool utility. You might not find a really good recent use at first, but this can be really used with a conjunction of other projects. So let me show you. Let's take a look at a few options of Enter, which are quite nice in my opinion. The first one will be the dash C option. So dash C. What that does is it clears the screen before you before it runs the command. So that's really useful. So you can see it right here. If I were to type some random stuff, it doesn't appear. So if I were to do like, this is another new line, right? You can see that for a brief moment, it just clears the screen and then it, you know, runs the command. So that's one thing. Another one is, let's get it back here. The other one is dash P. So to illustrate that point right here, okay, so I'm just gonna redo the command. So to illustrate the point right here, I'm gonna remove the hi.ox, hi.log, and hi.pdf files. Okay, I'll remove those. So now if I ls, I only have the hi.txt. So now ls hi.txt, pipe that into enter, give it the dash p option, and then the whole command, that is pdf latex hi.txt to hi.pdf. Okay, now if I run this, you can see that because I gave the dash P option, it doesn't run the command at the start, but it ran if we don't give the command. Okay, let's ls again. You can see that it still has just has hi.txt. Okay, let's copy this. Let's, you know, go here and paste this. This is another new, give it another new. And if I write it now, you can see that now it ran the command. So you can see the output right here. If I ls, you can see the output. So the dash p option is really good when you want it to run the utility only if the file changes, and don't run it at the start. That's another feature that it has. That's the options that are really cool. Let's run it again. Let's write, and if I write it again, it does indeed recompile or run the command again. So you basically, if you want to force it, you can say you can just rewrite the file, or you can just press you can press the space key, and that recompiles as well. If we scroll down in the man page, you can see the commands section here. There are two keys which enter will look for: q for quit and space to execute it at the whenever you want it. So that's basically what I showed right here. But the space, it just runs it again. Okay, so that's Enter. Enter can be used in a variety of different ways, and it's really cool. And if you want to use it, definitely get it from the main repos of your distribution of choice. If you're on Debian, it's available in the apt install enter should fix it. And if you're on Arch Linux like I am, you can just do pacman-s, or let me show you, sudo pacman-s enter, and that will give it you enter. So it's a really small program, 0.03 megabytes. Get it installed and play around with it. Now I also use enter for my DWM status bar. Let me just quickly show you DWM status. Okay, yes. So I have a file in my system. Okay, let's increase the font size a bit. Let's cut out the file /temp/DWM status. So this has some text here, and basically that text is what appears right here. I were to like refresh it, you can see this. So this is the same thing. I just use ls the file. I pipe it into enter like I showed before, and then I run the command. So I use the -s option here because I want this. I want a command substitution, and -s basically means where did it go? Okay, I think I don't have it here. Let's run it again. Let's put it there. Quit. Go again. -s. There you go. So basically -s means use the shell. So I have I think /bin/sh or dsh, I forgot. But anyways, it basically does that. So that's also really cool. Now if you want to just see an example, I can echo something stf and put that in the /temp/dwm-status, and you can see my status bar on the top updates. So it just came back again because the date update. So yeah, I would run it a few times, you can see how it works. Okay, so that's it for the video on enter. If you like the video, just give it a like, subscribe and all that stuff. If you want to watch my video somewhere that is not YouTube, you can watch it on Odyssey. And also if you want to support me and give me some money or donate to me, you can donate to me on Patreon or on PayPal. And also join my Discord server, where I have early access content posted and a few blogs and all that stuff. And as always, this video will have a blog or a written form of the video in the video description, or it can be available in my site as well. So definitely check this out, and thanks for watching this video guys. Hope you're safe, and yeah, see you another time.